भगवद गीता 5 इज कर्म संन्यास और कर्म वैराग्य. व्हाट वाज 1, 2, 3, 4? हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू रिमेम्बर? व्हाट इज 1? 1 वाज इजी. व्हाट इज द नेम?
अर्जुन विषाद.
अर्जुन विषाद योग. विषाद मीन्स व्हाट?
सैड.
या व्हाट वाज ही सो सैड अबाउट?
He thought everyone else is his family, so he didn't want to.
Oh, he had many, many reasons. He was just in dvandva. What is dvandva? What was the conflict? To fight or not to fight? Dvandva. The state of dvandva gives rise to vishad. Correct? Yeah? Vishad is always an effect. I don't want to be sad, but I become sad because of something. And what is that? Because of dvandva in the mind. Should I do this or should I do this? Yes? One raga says do this, one dvesha says no, no, run away from this. Again, raga, dvesha, this pull and push, pull and push. Dvandva in the mind leads to vishad. Got it? That was the gist of Arjun Vishad Yoga, the dvandva in Arjuna's mind. Yes, and we went through all the shlokas, you remember? His mind comes up with different dvandvas. Oh, they are my family. Yeah, I love them. They took care of me. Yeah. Then another dvandva, will they be alive after this? Will they still live? Oh, if I have to get all this at the cost of my family, then I don't want it at all. He comes up with different ways of escaping the situation. Yes, that was Arjuna Vishad Yoga. What was second?
Sankhya Yoga.
Second is Sankhya. What is Sankhya? What is Sankhya Yoga?
Intellectual engagement.
Huh? And how, what was the gist of Sankhya? What did we do?
This is to know yourself and God through your learning and through your knowledge.
Yes, perfect. Who am I? The search for yourself through intellectual reasoning was Sankhya.
And we need pencils, they're here.
Yeah, he tells him, look beyond the body. You are not this body, you just had this body. Remember? He tells him that these people were there before, these people will be there. Later also, even if they move out of this body, do not be stuck to the body. You are not the Prakriti, you are Purusha. Yeah. So he kept repeating that and intellectually kind of poking him to get out of it. How do you pull somebody out of sadness? Poke his ego. Tell him, what will the world say? Yeah. You are a Kshatriya. People look up to you. Yeah. You are an ideal. People want to follow you. And what are you doing? Running away from battle? That's what Krishna did. He poked his ego also in Sankhya. Remember? So he used different ways in Sankhya again to get him out of his vishad. Did that work?
No.
If it had worked, Bhagavad Gita would have been over in 2 chapters. It did not work for Arjuna. So then he goes on to chapter 3. What was chapter 3?
Karma Yoga.
What does he teach him in Karma Yoga?
You have to do your action.
Action is neither good nor bad.
Yeah. And the main part of Karma Yoga?
Don't worry about karma.
Perfect.
detachment.
Gita ji knows Gita very well.
Detachment.
Yeah, he says, drop the karma phalam. Just focus on the karma or the kritya. Don't get confused with sanchita karma, prarabdha karma and agami karma. You focus on your action or the kritya. Yeah? And drop this. What will this action lead to? Will it be good or bad? Yeah. And then Arjuna is like, oh, how can I do action without karma phalam? I will be so lost. What is the point? Yeah, we keep running after karma phalam. That is why we do an action. And he keeps explaining through different ways. Yeah, why? Karma is important and not karma phalam. That was karma yoga. Yeah. Did Arjuna learn?
No.
Then Krishna went on to chapter number 4. What was that?
Gana karma yoga.
Okay. What was chapter number 4? Gyan yoga. Yeah. Okay, you don't understand karma. That's fine. Let me use some jnana. And he emphasized and re-emphasized why jnana is important. Yeah. He says, jnana is higher than karma yoga. So then he says, okay, then why are you making me do this bad karma of fighting this battle? Let me run away to the Himalayas. See, his mind in every way was looking for a loophole. Doesn't your mind do that? You know, when you have to make that tough decision, your mind is not ready to, you know, gather the courage. Okay, it's okay. This might be tough for me, but let me do it. It wants to run away from that. It wants to take the easy way out and it will find any reason to do that. That's exactly the state of Arjuna. So now he's saying, oh, if you're saying karma is, you know, above karma is jnana, let me drop this karma. Let me run away. So this is where Arjuna fails again in Gyan Yoga, and we come to chapter number 5. What is it? And I just told you the name. Karma Sannyas. What is Karma Sannyas?
Dropping the karma, being centered.
Dropping
renunciation.
Yeah, dropping the action or renunciation of action is karma sannyas. In other words, I'll run away to the Himalayas and I'll sit there. Yeah, this is a great solution Arjuna has come up with. Yeah, so now how Krishna talks him out of that also. I'm sure he's going to find another way now out of that also. But at least maybe you find your enlightenment in this chapter. You never know. So karma sannyas is also called karma vairagya. Same. Yeah. In some scriptures were translated as karma sannyas and some translated as karma vairagya. Same thing.
Does it mean dispassion from action?
Like renouncing the action and going away. Yeah. Now, it's not wrong. It's tough. It's very tough. That's exactly what Krishna is going to explain now. It's very tough. It's not as easy as just saying, okay, anyway, I'm not the doer. I'm going to sit on the couch. But you're sitting on the couch. That is also an action. Not doing. The state in the mind of not doing, I am not going to do, is also an action. This is what Krishna is going to explain in detail to him. Yeah? So, most of you have done Ashtavakra, hands up? 90% in the room. I am not the doer. Yeah? If you've not been able to practice that Sakshi Bhav, this is your chance. This entire chapter is about non-doership. How to not be a doer while still being engaged in action with your child, your family, your friends, your office. Being in this world and not being a doer. How do I do this? Your answer is in this. So now Krishna is going to give you a technique which he gives you right at the end of the chapter. But I want you to start practicing it right now. At least by the end of the chapter you understand it. Otherwise, it's just going to remain words, and I don't want that intellectual understanding. So, number one, prana, apana. What is prana and apana? Most of you in Yoga Vashishta know. What is prana? Perfect. Inhaling. Inhaling. When, how does the prana go? It goes in from the nose and goes into the lungs. So I don't have a diagram of a person sitting here, but imagine this is the nose and this is the direction of your prana. Yeah? Second is apana. What is apana? The exact reverse. Yeah? In this it comes out. So this is the direction. In this is direction of apana. In between prana and apana, there is a gap. Have you noticed that gap? Yeah. What do we do in pranayama? We intentionally focus on that gap and hold. Breathe in, 2, 3, 4. This is prana. Then I hold. I'm holding at that gap. Hold, 2, 3, 4. Breathe out, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is apana. Again, there is a gap outside. Yes? So it is said, it's just a way of saying it, that it is about 12 inches away from your nose. Where does this gap outside occur? About 12 inches away from your nose. Now don't start looking for it. You're not going to find it, yeah, while breathing in and out. You have to just be attentive about the two gaps. That's it. That's the first part of the technique. Yeah, it sounds very simple, but when you actually go to do, it's very confusing initially. Yeah, so I want you to start today rather than telling you to do it as homework after 5. And what will we do? In both the gaps, we will just observe. You don't have to stop. You're breathing in, out, in, out. There is a gap. It might be minuscule, but the gap is there. Yes? Just pay attention to that gap. That's all you have to do. Observe that gap. Just keep observing, 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 observing. Yeah? In that gap, it is said, you will reach a door which helps you step within. It is called the door to enlightenment. Yeah? Right now, it's only theory. Yeah? You have to practice it. Yeah. So, we discussed about the prana and apana. Prana is the in-breath. Your breath goes in from the nostrils and into the lungs. This is the in-breath. Out-breath is from the lungs through the nostril and out. Yeah? So now when my out-breath comes out, and before I'm going to take the next inhalation, there is a gap. It might be a minuscule gap, but it is there. Just observe that. Yes? Remember Sakshi? Being a witness to it. Not jumping in and saying, oh, this is the gap. Oh, no, I didn't get the gap. Oh, I like the gap. Oh, I don't like the gap. Nonsense. Drop it.
Can we like measure it like this?
Like a ruler or something?
Please don't do that.
Exactly.
No measuring of anything. Yeah? Just observe when I breathe out, when I breathe in, there is a gap. Just observe that there is a gap. That's all. Being a sakshi, being a witness. Yes? Just be a witness. No saying I like, no saying I dislike. Just observe, even if your mind starts cribbing about it. Oh, so difficult. Oh, where is the gap? Observe. Just observe. You don't get involved. Witness means what? Witness means what? The one who sits on the fence. Does not get involved. No yes, no no. Nothing. Absolute silence. So you observe that there is this gap, and I had never observed it before. Clear? We've intentionally created such processes where the gap is extended. Yeah? But I want you to start observing even in your normal breath. Just in that normal breath in and normal breath out. It is there. Even right now you're breathing in and breathing out. It is there. It's minuscule. It's tiny, but the gap is there. Just focus on that gap. Yep, all set? So we'll practice the gap again. Close your eyes and you start breathing in and breathe out and observe the gap between the breath in and the breath out. And then observe the gap between the breath out and then the breath in. Yes? So just to get familiar with the music, first practice, yes, eyes closed. Deep breath in and out. Take another deep breath in and let go. And very slowly, open your eyes. Could you do it? Could you observe the gap? Even if it is minuscule. Or are you still confused? Honestly, tell me. Who else is still confused? Just observe that there is a gap. When the breath goes into the lungs, it goes in and there is a pause and then it comes out, and when it's about 12 inches away, again there is a pause before the next breath comes in. Just observe the pause. That's all you have to do. It's very simple.
But you end up observing the whole breathing process, right?
Very good.
That's the way it
works. Fantastic. You're getting there. At the end of the breath, you have to come and observe that minuscule little, whatever it is, fraction of a second, where there is stillness. You have to observe that. Got it? Question.
When you observe this, your breathing pattern is changing.
What's happening?
You try to hold it or like,
you know. You don't have to try and hold your breath. Breathe normally. Just observe it. Just observe it. You can observe it even right now. Even right now you're breathing, right? Yeah? You don't have to stop. You don't have to hold. You have to just observe that gap. That is the meeting point of the subtle body and the physical body. Yes? And you went into that gap for quite some time after the Kriya. You don't realize it. You lie down and you know, you think that you are sleeping, but actually you are somewhere deep down, pulled deep down into some kind of a force which you also don't realize, and your breath has come to a standstill and your mind has come to a standstill. It might happen for a few seconds. For the lucky ones, it happens for a few minutes. Yeah? You are in the gap.
The gap is like an anchor. It holds you in the meditation.
Perfect. Have you
this is the door to get in meditation.
Perfect.
Yeah, it brings a lot of, if you constantly practice this, I think it brings in a lot of calmness.
Yes.
And you enjoy it. I think someone said that they want to be in that, continue for it.
Yeah.
I think it, that situation happens.
Yes, that's true.
It's a great feeling.
Yeah, now that you've gone so much into knowledge, so now you want to understand it more. Yeah? This is that understanding that Krishna is going to give to you. It's in the last two sutras of that. Yeah? So it is, just get established in that gap, O Krishna, is the first technique. Yeah? So now you have to just start observing that gap. At least I take the first step. Get to understand what this gap is. So that is what your homework is for tonight. Before you sleep, 5 minutes, just observe the gap, observe the gap, and then go to sleep. You don't have to be really sitting. You can lie down and observe the gap. Yeah? Again in the morning when you wake up, before coming here, observe the gap for 5 minutes. With that intention, close your eyes and just observe the gap. Yes? And then I'll tell you technique number two tomorrow morning. It's not a separate technique. You add on to this. So you have to do this plus that. So at least get good in one. I mean, to add another one on top of it, you'll be like, oh, too much. Yes? Clear now? Yes. This weekend is for tapasvis. Huh? It's going to be tough. It's not just theory. Yes? So be ready for tapasvi. Okay, questions? Any questions about what you felt, or you want to share what you felt when you were in the gap? What else did you notice?
Two things. One is this keeps you in the Sakshibhav. Whenever you have, if you have followed the Sakshibhav, you'll have exactly it equalizes that. And the second thing also, it also focuses on your, absolutely on your breath.
Perfect. Very good observations. Yes, Uncle.
Well, it was a almost complete nothingness,
absence of anything, and like a vacuum, and imperceptible, and I think it's a natural process. When you are going this way, coming back, the system itself, I don't know, I'm not a, I don't know physiology, but the system might be like, it's almost imperceptible. Look, they're so conjoint.
Yes.
They're so close to each other.
Yes.
This is a, it was a, almost a difficult to make out.
Absolutely. Very true.
Well, what's the mystery of the colleges?
No mystery. It's the force of the breath. It goes out till there.
So also in meditation, when you're observing the breath, I mean, especially when you're looking, you know, you're observing the gap, you observe that the breath also, when your stomach is going out, your breath is coming in, so you feel, it's like a pendulum, it's a, you know, it's like a constant, like
a machinery breath, working together.
Yeah, like it's hooking in, and then you see your breath, you know, your stomach is coming in and your breath is going out, and then it's as if automatically everything is.
It's like a tube, like that.
Right.
It's just going. Like somebody, they sometimes in a circus they do this.
Yeah.
That's what it felt like.
Very nice.
In the beginning, I had trouble, I didn't know what I was observing. But during the kriya, it was very helpful. And especially the faster one to me helped more. And to me, today I experienced something that my part was getting deeper and deeper. That I had a little bit, that I felt I was doing from surface, the kriya so far. I mean, I could feel every time I am exhaling out, is coming from more down and down.
Deeper, yeah.
And there was really, towards the end it was just like, I mean, I'll be honest, in the long kriya I have always been, when it's going to be over, when it's going to be over. But today it was, I mean, I was enjoying it. I mean, it really made a difference in that system.
Very nice. What else did you observe? I'm waiting for something. And you know I'm waiting for it.
I kept looking for the Ronald.
Come on, all scholars in my class.
For me, just, you know, because I have to observe both ends all the time for the hour and a half. It made me just stay within, and it helped me to stay within rather than thinking about a thoughtlessness, just to stay within.
So there were no thoughts, no raga, thoughts. No dvesha,
no
absolutely
thoughts.
Inside.
And zero thoughts.
Very nice.
Well, also, this is probably not what you're looking for, but but it's just another activity, just another distractor from the distractions, right? It's giving you something to do, but it's almost like, you know, that pause is like, you know, there's no oxygen going to the brain. So this is this moment of silence, physically, right? It's like putting a plastic cup over an insect, and then it just slowly dies. Over and over again, over and over again.
But you were not dying, but something was dying.
The mind.
Yeah.
That's what I was waiting for.
Very quiet time, most quiet.
The mind dies when the breath movement stops. Didn't you do this last week in Yoga Vashishta? Yeah? The mind will stop when the movement of the breath is broken. The mind is related to the breath. Mind is the subtle body. Breath is in the physical body. Yes? Now, the physical body and the subtle body are conjoined. Where? What are those points called?
Chakra.
Perfect. chakras, the seven chakras, is where the subtle body or the mind meets the physical body. And what are these chakras? Nothing but the nadis intersecting. Yes? And which are the three main nadis you have done? Ida, Pingala and Sushumna. What does Ida and Pingala coincide with? The right and left nostril. So Ida and Pingala are two nadis of the subtle body, and they coincide with the right and left nostril in the physical body. So when I breathe in and I breathe out, the Ida and Pingala energy is going up and down, up and down. But what happens in the gap? The Sushumna Nadi is the one that is like getting triggered. Have you seen that gas lighter? You have to trigger it, no? That trigger. First spark is required. That spark happens to the Sushumna Nadi only in the gap. Those who found this too high funda, it's okay. But most of you got it, right? So the Sushumna Nadi is the one that gets triggered. It's that the first lighter katak that you're doing in the gap. The more you are observant about the gap, the more you're triggering the Sushumna Nadi. Yes, and your energy starts moving from the lower chakras to the higher chakras. Very scientific Sudarshan Kriyas. All these pranayams are really very beautifully designed. So, now what happens with this? Exactly what he said. Because the movement of the breath equals to the movement of the mind. This we remember from Yoga Vaisishta. This has been repeated again and again and again and again. When the movement of the breath stops, the movement of the mind also comes to a standstill. That is why we break the rhythm of the breath in Kriya. At the end, what happens? Because of breaking the rhythm so many times, the mind finally gives up and comes to a halt. Happened today also? When you lie down in the end, at least for a few moments, you were not even breathing and you're absolutely thoughtless. Few fractions of seconds, you were in the gap. That gap had got expanded for that few minutes or whatever that was, however long it was. Got it? Understood the beauty of the gap? Yeah? Now we are going to keep practicing this. Yes? Now you have to keep observing this gap while breathing in and out, in and out. Yeah. So throughout tomorrow's day and Sunday, every 1.5-2 hours, I will put on a music just for 2 minutes. We will close our eyes and just observe the breath. And I'll add a step two to this technique tomorrow morning. But before that, I need you to practice being in the gap. That's your homework number one for tonight. Before sleeping, 2 minutes, just close your eyes and observe the gap. Just observing, witnessing. No right, wrong, yes, no, I like this, I don't like this. No intellectual talk. Observing it. Being a witness to it. Sitting on the fence and observing the gap. That's all. Here? Everybody. So now we go on to Guruji's talk on Bhagavad Gita 5. So it's a very short talk, not very long. So first we watch Guruji's talk and then we'll discuss it. It's a very, very short talk because it was probably done at the end of the day like this, where people are just coming. And Guruji just comes in, gives his attendance, says hi and bye. So So you can watch his attendance. Yeah. And then I'll give you homework number 2 after that.